The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Herod was the one who had John the Baptist arrested and bound in prison on account of Herodias, the wife of his brother Philip, whom he married. And John said to Herod, "It is not lawful for you to have your brother's wife." Herodias harbored a grudge against him and wanted to kill him, but was unable to do so. Herod feared John, knowing him to be a righteous and holy man, and kept him in custody. When he heard him speak, he was very much perplexed, yet he liked to listen to him. She had an opportunity one day when Herod, on his birthday, gave a banquet for his courtiers, the military officers, and the leading men of Galilee. Herodias's own daughter came in and performed a dance and delighted Herod and his guest. The king said to the girl, "Ask of me whatever you wish, and I will grant it to you." He even swore many things to her, "I will grant you whatever you ask of me, even to half of my kingdom." She went out and said to her mother, "What shall I ask for?" And the mother replied, "The head of John the Baptist." The girl hurried back to the king's presence and made her request, "I want you to give me at once on a platter the head of John the Baptist." The king was deeply distressed, but because of his oaths and the guest, he did not wish to break his word to her. So he promptly dispatched an executioner with orders to bring back his head. He went off and beheaded him in the prison. He brought in the head on a platter and gave it to the girl. The girl in turn gave it to her mother. When his disciples heard about it, they came and took his body and laid it in a tomb. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Duha ka tawo ginaselebrar ang iya death day sa simbahan kay Jesus, Good Friday, kay St. John, August 29, His Passion and Death today. Aton gina-celebrate naton birthday. Subong gintugangan naton baptismal day. Bilang Katoliko gina-celebrate naton baptismal day. Well, gina-celebrate man ang death day anniversary, pero not as a feast of the church, but as a petition. We pray for the souls in purgatory on their death anniversary. But for John the Baptist, his passion and death is being celebrated in the church and embedded, so to say, instituted in the church calendar. And the whole church, from Rome to other parts of the world, even in La Paz, Naro Cathedral, today celebrates the Feast of the Passion of St. John the Baptist, his death day. Ano ang lesson naton nga makuha? Maghambal ako lesson, hindi ni lesson sang ano ha, sang eskwelahan, moral lesson, spiritual lesson. Kay man nag-text sa akon nga lesson ako kuno, spiritual lesson na. Life is a lesson. Maling kang kitid ang imuya pag-define sang lesson. Nabi mo yung lesson, nahadlok ka kay tagaan ka exam. Diyan muna. May mga lessons kita in life. Ga-learn kita sa to say, kay disciple kita ni Christ. Students kita. Gina-form kita sa siya school. Kagang faith naton demands ang intellectual aspect, heart aspect, action aspect. Ang problema sa Katoliko, nag-expect sang aksyon nga wala kay intindi sa iya pagtuo. That's why bisan ipa-define mong love sa iya ya, lain niya definition kay tiwala sa iya concept sang love sa Bible. Nang iya love ya hatag kagamuna. Why sa iya sang theology nga mo ni nga love? That's why tiko. Munang isang yung love. Purang definition niya sang labia, iya sang secular definition. Kay why siya nag-learn? Na-close niyang iya ha, mind sa gusto niya lang mabatian, amo lang na iya gusto niya. Bad ina, why kagagross ina? Ako gusto ko ya maka-learn. Pero sa inyo gusto niyo mag-learn. Pero hindi learn nga intellectual exercise, para kabalo ka sang imo pagtuo. Mapangabuhi mo. Amo nang purpose. So maghambal ako diya lesson. Hindi niya lesson. Yung lesson 1, lesson 2. Hindi moral lessons. Ina. May lesson gani ang fables. May lessons gani kay Christ. That's why, anong lessons natin makuha? Ang learnings natin makuha? Iban allergic sa term na lesson. Do matyag nila daw, na-insulto sila kayo, grade 1 sila. Hindi mo na. Hindi na yung tuyo kung himong mga daw grade 1. Hindi na yan. Tatay ko mong spiritual ako. Father ako. Gusto ko magtudlo. Gusto ko i-share sa inyo ang ginatudlo sa simbahan. Duty na sa akon. Pero ginabutangan ko delight. May delight siya. Duty siya. Hindi hapos mo. Hindi kung hindi hapos, hindi duty mo. Duty. Pero kinalan mo, tangan mo ang delight sa truth. Di subong, ang aton nga spiritual lesson, butangan ko na gano'n ang spiritual lesson, moral lesson, ang fortitude, strength. Strength sa ano? Sa tatlo ka challenges. Aranda sa Bible. Temptations of the flesh, temptations of the world, temptations from Satan o attack from Satan. Attack ni Satan yati, exorcism kita eh. Kag-aton mga sacramentals, most especially confession. Kaya ang attack ya sa sin, dumduman niyo tong attack ya. Primero, temptations lang. And then, oppression. Di ba? And then, obsession. And then, complacency. Ano eh? Infestation. Pero ang pinaka-last yung attack sa imo is possession. Di, wala pa naman ngunos na possess diri. Tlagsa lang na. Pero temptation, aragida. So that's why kinanglan tang fortitude. So ang fortitude sa ano? Sa kay Satan. Fortitude sa flesh. Meaning to say, sa interior passion mo. Dala-dala mo ang temptation. Dira kay weak ang imo flesh. Ang imo passion. Interior. Kag world external. Na, may temptation sa external world. Mga corruption, mga pornography, mga binastos, mga damo sa world. Basta may himo sa la, mga bribery, mga kunanuda, daya, na, kuno nga temptation, diriya sa sulod, ano, pride, lust, envy, na. So kinanglan nato ng fortitude against sa tining fronts, si Satan, sa aton mismo flesh, kag sa world. Di kunway ka na kaya kabalo, nabimi ko na nulang fortitude, piliin mo lang, hindi ka kapangaman. That's why ginatudlo, pangaman. Exorcism, sa flesh iayati, examination of conscience, kaganudira, kag sa world, obey the Ten Commandments. Kaya ang Ten Commandments, protection mo na against the world. Kaya ang world iatakihon ka, pero kung may Ten Commandments ka, no, amuning hambal ni Lord. Yung iban nga mga teachings, truth, love, faith, mga armors ta na. fortitude against temptation, negative. Pero may fortitude man nga positive, to do good works. Maging maisog ka, may strength ka, not only to resist and avoid evil, but to do good. Piliun mong good. Sa tanan-tanan ng oras sa kabuhi mo, tingwaon mo mapiliun ang what is good. Kag ang what is good is always related to God, to worship of God. Hindi sa akong pleasure. Kaya kung pleasure na nakaroon, temptation man ang pleasure. Kundi kung anong will ni Lord, anong good, anong worship kay Lord is good for me. Pero kung ano ang satisfaction ko is not necessarily good for the Lord. That's why ang aton criteria sang good is not found in us, it's found in the Lord, in His Word. Because He's only the one who is good. Teacher, good master, what shall I do to inherit eternal life? Ah, you tell me what good? Why do you call me good? Ginpa-define sa iyan ni Christ, gintuduan siya. Correct na, kay ang good ya Dios, hindi diri ang good. Pero ang tao, si Adam, gusto niya define ang good apart from God. That's why nagsala siya, nagseparar siya. What is good life apart from God? Masala kagid. What is good music apart from the worship of God? O ano da? No. What is good life? What is good? Wala Dios, your life is not good, morally good. Because good comes from God. That's why to do good, meaning, gina-presume, makilala mo ang Dios, kinasunod mo siya. Pero kung wala ka sang Dios, hindi good ang ma-attain mo. Pleasure, happiness lang, but not holiness. That's why may fortitude man siya to do good. Gapangayo kita sa adlaw-adlaw. In fact, isa ina sang mga cardinal virtues. Okay? Fortitude sa aton kabuhi. Ti si John, ngin pangabuhi ya gini, strength sa temptation, even unto death. Kag part sang fortitude, long suffering, patience, perseverance. Ang reward tungod sang perseverance, hindi tungod sang virtue nga faith. Kung ang faith mo subong lang pero hindi magpersevere, wala reward. Tanan nga virtues nga hindi ka persevere, wala reward. Kaya ang reward sa perseverance, sa long suffering. Naglove ka subong, hindi ka man faithful, ano reward mo? Nagbulig ka sa isig katao, hindi man sigi-sigi, anong reward mo? Temporaryo man lang. That's why ang banal ni Christ, persevere. Even in prayer. Kaya ang reward iya sa perseverance, ang banal ni Christ, so, tanan man, no? Pero stand up and persevere. Kaya ang test sang faith is not in the initial faith, it is in the finished faith, in the product faith, which is the fruit of perseverance. Kagamuning kay St. John the Baptist, may fortitude siya, kag may perseverance. Kag in perseverance siya, remarkable, even unto death. Ako kung kaisa, pagbasa ako sa niya, may perseverance ako, may long suffering ako, gamay-gamay lang nga irritations, gamay-gamay lang nga inconvenience. Hindi na ko yaka persevere. Wala ako, kulang ako sa fortitude. Hindi ka persevere to witness to your faith. Si St. John, persevere gid siya. Hasta pa sa prisuhan. Nanindugan siya sa kamatuuran. Kaginpugutan siya ulo. Tub-tub sa kamatayon, ginang ya-witnessing kay Christ. Timeditate na, ako ma-meditate man. Bilang pari, ano iya ang extent sang akon fortitude? Kaganong suffering nga gin-offer ko kay Lord? Ambal ni San Pablo, naka-experience bala ka mo sang suffering and witnessing kay Lord even to the extent of shedding your blood? handa bala kamo maka-witness sa inyo pagkakatoliko? Tubtub sa pag-ula ninyo sang dugo? O kung gamay-gamay lang reklamo, nga ginuot simbahan, tiway ka na sang suffering, nga lawaay ang ano. Tapos pagtuo, pabugaan, pagtuo ako, katoliko ko, hindi ka nga nika-suffer sang inconvenience for the sake of worship. Na-challenge ko na, ha? Kita sinatanan, huwag ko na nagpakanami, kaya ako amuman na, ako is amuna. Well, the spirit is willing but the flesh is weak. Niragid matestingan. Anyway, wala man kitang ginatagaan sang Dios, sang bagay nga hindi natin masarangan, kaya kung hindi natin masarangan, ginadugangan niya man sang grasya. Kaya wala man siya ga-demand sang bagay nga waya ginhatag sa aton. Oras mag-demand ang Ginoo, butang balon may ginhatag siya sa imo. Mag-demand siya sa imong pag-asawahay, may ginhatag siya nga grasya sa kasal. Mag-demand siya sa pagkapari, sang ordinasyon mo ginhatagan niya kasi na sang grasya. Balikan mo na, i-celebrate mo na, i-glory, ano mo na, i-thank youhan mo na, balikan mo na, kay may grasya, natawag ina grace of the state of life. Galing nga nalimtan mo na, hindi ka gabalik. So balik, that's why mo nang meaning sang anniversary, na balikan mo ang grasya para i-revive mo naman for a year, pangabuhi naton ina. So, sundo naton si St. John, hindi ayhan sa shedding din sang blood, kundi sa perseverance na lang adlaw-adlaw sa aton ordinary life. Kag kun maidiman ang Dios sa aton, inatungod may ginhatag siya nga una na sa aton. Kag kun hindi naton matuman, tungod sa aton weaknesses, faults and falls, natawag naton, say sorry, then stand up again and persevere. Hindi ka guro mariwardan sa martyrdom, pero mariwardan ikaw sang perseverance. From time to time, ga-tumbalay ikaw, ga-tumba ikaw, ga-fail ikaw, pero ga-persevere, bangon. Tumba naman, bangon. So ang fortitude natin, hindi iya sa iya, pero nga patamatayon martyrdom. Pero I think para sa ato ng fortitude is daily perseverance sa aton faith. And then dangup perme sa grasya sang Dios. Tindog naman, bangon naman, mag-witness. Fortitude, if not, daily perseverance. Amen. God our Father, you called John the Baptist to be a herald of your son's birth and death. As he gave his life in witness to truth and justice, so may we strive to profess our faith in your gospel. Grant this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.